At this point, we almost have our heading 2 tag solid. You'd think we'd have it totally squared away by now, but there's one more little thing we have to take note of. If we jump over to the mockup, you see that we're pretty good for this heading, it looks the same, but if you scroll down to this written by our team section, the border down here is a different color. So how do we deal with this? Well, we need a way to identify this heading as different from the other headings. And though we'll ultimately use a slightly different approach, the easiest solution is to use something called a class. Let's take a look at what a class looks like. I'm going to jump back to our editor, and we have our three headings here. What I'm going to do first is change the text in these headings so we know which ones we're dealing with. So the second heading is going to be called Written by Our Team. And then if we go back to the mockup and scroll down, the third heading is Contact Us. And I'll add an extra line here to separate it from the image. We'll save this. So the way we can use a class on this heading, which has the different border color, is by using the class property. So we'll do class equals, and let's just call this different. For now, that's descriptive enough, though eventually we'll find better class names that are more descriptive of what this actually is. So this class, on its own, isn't going to change anything about how this tag works. However, it does give us a way to identify just elements with this class in our selectors. And the way we can do that is with a dot. The only selector we've used so far is H2, and as you can see, we don't need any special character to say, hey, this is supposed to be applied to H2 tags. With classes, however, we use a dot. So let's create our selector here. We'll use dot, different, we'll create an opening and a closing bracket, and let's add some very obvious CSS change so we can know for sure that we're applying CSS just to this element. So I'll change the color to purple. All right, let's save this and jump back to the browser and refresh. And now you can see that our text is purple here, but the other two are gray. Great, so we're identifying just this element. Now what we really want to do is change the border on the bottom to white. So let's do that instead. I'll jump back to the editor, and here we'll change the border bottom color to white, and we'll save it.